this country, is there a correlation, a relationship, now that we have this increase in wages? Will we begin to see a decrease in the poverty index?
Not necessarily. Poverty is a function of productivity. And even if I increase your salaries, if there's no increase in productivity, the value of that currency or the value of your salary will reduce to the point. So what we should be looking at is how to ensure that the Nigerian worker can be more productive. And how are you going to achieve this? You need new investments, and you need existing investments. Investments in power, investments in energy, petroleum, investment in manufacturing, investment in agriculture, and investments. Investments come about because people know that they will get a return on their investment. The return on the investment is a function of pricing. If I cannot price my electricity at the cost reflective tariff levels, then I'm not going to invest. If you do not invest in electricity, there's a correlation between electricity output and productivity. So we need to address some of those issues. Built into our report were a number of adjustments that needed to be made, that needs to be made. Some of them voluntary, most of them involuntary, some imperative, some necessary, and then a few optional.
So it's now poor of the poor that we're facing.
Poor versus the very poor.
Poor versus the very,
very
poor. That's what we're facing in the country.
There
are no rich people in this country.
No, there are rich people, but their quantum are so few. So let's say maybe 4 or 5% of Nigerians own. Right, but there's a physical constraint to. No matter how rich you are, you're unlikely to eat 5 times a day. After 3 times, you'll be saturated. You cannot go into 2 cars at the same time. You're unlikely to be able to sleep on 2 beds at the same time. So there's a physical constraint to how much you can consume. Consumption is what drives the economy. So it's important that revenues, right, and income percolate down the pyramid so that people can spend more. And if they spend more, then output will increase. But when you have inequitable distribution of income and opportunity, the rich that can only physically spend so much, and that's a constraint. So we need to see some kind of democratic change in the consumption and income pattern so that the people at the bottom of the pyramid can are empowered to spend more, and that will create jobs.